ISP versus residential proxies. Which one is faster, better, cheaper? Stay tuned as we compare these two proxy types. First off, what is an ISP proxy? ISP proxies are remote servers that route your network connection and change your IP address by landing their own. These proxies are registered with internet service providers such as AT&T or Spectrum. So, when you visit a website, it appears as if you're a regular user, even though it's a server chilling in a data center. The great thing about ISP proxies, they offer high speed and reliability. Since ISP IPs don't depend on a user's connection, they're always available when you need them. Plus, many proxy providers offer dedicated IP options, allowing you to keep the same IP for as long as you need. Another major perk of ISP proxies is high anonymity. Since ISP proxies are tied to internet service providers, they're less likely to get flagged or detected compared to regular data center IPs. But nothing's perfect, including ISP proxies. One downside is low subnet diversity. Many ISP IPs come from the same subnet, so if a few IP addresses get blocked, others in that range might also be at risk. One more downside is the limited geographic coverage. ISP proxies don't have as many global locations, so they're not the best choice when you need regional IPs. Now, let's talk about the alternative, residential proxies. Unlike ISP proxies, these are actual devices like laptops, tablets, or desktop computers connected to a local network, but the rest is similar. When you connect to a residential proxy, it reroutes your traffic and changes your IP. The perks of residential proxies include IP diversity. With this proxy type, you get access to a broad range of subnets and wider geo coverage. Another advantage is top-level anonymity and success rate. Because residential proxies come from real devices, they are nearly undetectable, which helps ensure smooth performance while steering clear of IP blocks. Yet, everything has its cost. For all the perks, you'll have to deal with less predictable response times. Since residential proxies rely on real users' internet connections, the network speed is generally slower than for ISP proxies. But you can still find fast and reliable residential service. For example, ProxyWay's proxy market research shows that our residential IPs have a response time of under 0.5 seconds. That's faster than some ISP proxies from other providers. One more thing to keep in mind. All residential proxies are rotating, meaning your IP will change automatically as you use them. So, if you need a static IP, residential proxies might not be the best fit. Oh, and if someone mentions static residential proxies, they usually refer to ISP proxies. Now, we've covered perks and drawbacks of ISP and residential proxies, but when should you use each proxy type? ISP proxies are best for creating and managing multiple e-commerce accounts, SEO monitoring, large-scale scraping projects, market research, mass purchasing limited edition items, and so on. Meanwhile, you should use residential proxies for any website with strict protection measures or for use cases where you need very precise geo-targeting. These include accessing sneaker stores, social media networks, pricing aggregators. Other use cases include ad tech, accessing geo-restricted content, multi-accounting, and anonymous web scraping. As you can see, some use cases overlap, so the last thing to consider is the price, and here it gets a bit tricky. Whether ISP or residential proxies are cheaper varies by proxy provider. Yet, the general rule is if you need a lot of traffic, residential IPs are more cost-effective. But if you aim for dedicated IPs or your projects require connection stability and high network speeds, ISP proxies are better. By the way, we offer flexible ISP proxy plans where you can pay per gigabyte to use static ISP proxies from a shared pool, or you pay per IP to get dedicated ISP proxies. Now you know how to choose between ISP and residential proxies. If you still have any questions left, watch our Proxy Basics playlist or leave it in the comments. And I'll see you next time.